What's up, you guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today is going to be an interesting day. I'm about to go over to St. Louis and go to the International Grocery Store, and I'm about to try some exotic fruits. I did try one exotic fruit that I'm pretty sure I'm about to buy today. I tried it for the very, very, very first time when I was in Malaysia back in 2019 when I was over there celebrating my birthday. So make sure you guys go check that video out. But here we go, going to St. Louis. I don't live in St. Louis, but I am about to go over to St. Louis. I live really close. So I'm about to go over there on the south side, which is, you know, where my little high school is. And we're about to go shopping. So come shop with me, you guys. I'm so excited for this store. I haven't been in this store in it's been years because, you know, it's not like it's in my neighborhood. I have to travel about 30 minutes to get here. So let's go enjoy. And I'll show you a little bit more just of the store besides the fruit. It's very multicultural in St. Louis, especially on the south side. So let's just go in and I'm gonna show you, okay? So I am here. I just arrived at the grocery store. So here is where I'm going. It's called Jade International. I hope you guys can see this. So this is where I will be going. Okay, now I'm back at home, guys. I got all the fruit that I decided to get, and we're just gonna go down the list. And while you're at it, make sure you hit that subscribe button. So the fruits I got today, I got some pomegranate, and our tofu mango, a Thai banana. As you can see, it's a lot smaller than, you know, the typical banana, and it's a little off-colored. This is called the ugly fruit, calabaza, which is Spanish squash / pumpkin. And I got some jackfruit here. Big old slice of jackfruit. So now this is, I know you've seen these in your local grocery stores. It is still exotic to me. This is a pomegranate right here, and I'm going to like cut it up for you guys. So a pomegranate is one of the most ancient fruits. Originated in Persia, and it has a lot of health benefits, like help prevent type 2 diabetes that runs in my family, and it has a lot of anti-inflammatory properties. So very rich in antioxidants. And I'm just cutting it up here, and the part that you eat are the seeds. So I got my spoon here, and I'm just gonna like kind of scrape out the seed. And like I say, this is, it's really high in vitamin C and fiber and vitamin K. So that's some of the seeds I'm not gonna show. Here are the seeds here. Really, really good. And don't worry, I cleaned all my fruit beforehand. Took a lot of preparation for this. I had to go travel about 20 minutes just to get to the fruit. That's pretty good there. So, and this one is the tofu mango. And as you can see, and when I first bought it, it was green because it wasn't ripe yet, and then over few days it turned yellow, which means it is right. I'm just going to get rid of this little sticker here. And this is a Mexican mango. You can, the difference is this little oblong shape it has here. And the thing is, you want to make sure it's real soft. See how, well, you can't see, but it's really soft, and it has a very buttery, creamy consistency. So I'm just gonna take this and like cut it up. And it's really, really sweet, so you might want to be careful with these. Ooh. This is really sweet, guys, so like I say, be careful. Really high in vitamin C, fiber, calcium. Only has about 105 calories. Really sweet. Really sweet. Next fruit I have is a Thai banana. As you can see, it's really small compared to, you know, our bigger bananas. It's about 5 inches long. Of course, the name Thai comes from Thailand, which I did go for my birthday last year, 2019, sorry. And this little fruit was everywhere because over in Thailand, you know, the banana trees are just everywhere. They produce so many bananas, you will probably never run out. But most of the time they cook, they fry them. They slice them long ways and they fry them. I'm not a fan of fried foods. However, I did bake mine here. I would leave the recipe down below, but this is what it looked like when I baked it. And this is my little sauce I use. It's maple syrup, cinnamon, and ginger. It's really good. Yeah. Like I said, you can fry it. You have all different recipes for the different type of sauce you can use. I just told you what I use: maple syrup, cinnamon, and ginger. I didn't have any nutmeg, so I didn't use it, but still, nonetheless, awesome sauce. Now, the next fruit that I have right here is called the, I tore the sticker off, but it's called the ugly fruit. This fruit, it comes from Jamaica, and the Jamaicans actually gave it its name because they say it's ugly. But I don't think it's ugly. I think it's pretty cute. It is fully ripe. It was still, you still see some like greenish discoloration throughout. But when I first bought it, it was completely green. So I had to let it ripe also. But like I said, this is also known as the Tangelo. And like I said, you can find this in places like Jamaica. It's about 47 calories, about 12 carbs, and no fat. No fat, y'all. No fat. So this is like, and it's like a cross between the orange, the grapefruit, like all the other fruit. It has so many benefits, especially like weight loss and the immune system. And we need, and I need a strong immune system. Sorry, that's the cinnamon. Got me coughing like this. The cinnamon from the Thai banana over there. But yes, this is the ugly fruit. I'm about to cut it up for you to see, so you can see what it looks like. This is what it looks like. See? Kind of like an orange and a grapefruit. Let's move on to the next fruit we got. I got jackfruit here. Now, if you ever seen a jackfruit in the store, it's huge. It's really, it's like, I kid you not, this big. It's bigger than my head. And it weighs about 15, 20 pounds. But you can also buy some that's already pre-sliced for you. Now, this fruit is, you can find it, it originates in Malaysia, which, by the way, was the first time I ever had jackfruit, was when I was in Malaysia. I would see these in my local grocery store. Not the store that I went to, but I never got it because, first of all, it's heavy as hell, and I didn't feel like carrying it. So when I noticed that they sell it like this, pre-cut for you, I decided to get it. Like I say, first time ever trying jackfruit was when I was in Malaysia. Make sure you guys check out that video. I'll leave a suggestion up here somewhere. But yeah, this is what it looked like. It takes a lot of work to get to the core of this too, so kind of like a watermelon, it's a lot of preparation. So if you don't want to do that, just buy the pre-sliced one, and this is what it looked like. Now, another thing about jackfruit is this unripe flesh right here on the sides of it. See that? It's a meat substitute, kind of similar to like pulled pork and pulled chicken or whatever. And you can just like put it in the oven and you can actually eat it that way. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to eat it just as it is, so. It's kind of, it's sweetish. Like I said, when I was in Malaysia, it kind of tastes like a much sweeter banana a little bit, because it is pretty sweet. Another thing about this is, if you have any type of allergies to latex, or that birch pollen, you might want to be careful when you're handling a jackfruit, okay? But It is good too. Now the last thing I got here is called calabaza, which is a Spanish squash. Never had it before, as the name say. You can find this, it's mainly come from Latin America or whatever. Most people bake with this and use it in like stir fries, whatever. I did bake mine too. I baked it up right along with my Thai banana. So this is what all I used was olive oil, salt, and pepper, and I just heated up in the oven and got it all soft and tender. Good source of vitamin A, fiber. Pretty good. It's not sweet. I mean, it's squash. If you know what squash tastes like, that's what it tastes like. I mean, it tastes like a potato almost. And squash. I never really had squash. I never bought a squash, let's put it like that, but I have tried foods that have a little squash in it, but this is the first time I ever bought a squash and baked it, and it is delicious. It's good. I can roll with it. So y'all, oh yeah, forgot. Last thing, got some oolong tea. You can see that, they sell this there too. Got it from the same store. I got the jackfruit from somewhere else because they didn't have the jackfruit at the international grocery store that I went to that I showed you guys. But I did get this oolong tea. As you can see, this is a Chinese tea. And it's really good. I have had oolong tea before. It's very plain. It's just it's a mix of like green tea leaves, but it's pretty good. Like this one, even though it's cold, I had it in my refrigerator. But you can heat it up or you can drink it cold too, but I did clean off the can, so I don't need y'all coming to me. Cleaned off everything very well before I prepared this video. Very plain taste, as I always say to them. There is no sugar in here, so there's no calories, no sugar. This is about 11 and a half ounces here. You can see that. My hand's all messy, but I've been to this store before in the past to get like actually food. I wanted to try different foods, and I'm so thankful to have such a store like this in my area that I can go to. But this is just my take on different type of exotic fruits that I'm not used to eating. And so if you ever want to try some exotic fruits, here you go. Till next time, it's your local grocery store and you want to know what it tastes like. Well, I pretty much told you what it tastes like, at least what it tastes like to me. And I enjoyed all this fruit here. And make sure you guys hit that subscribe button. Okay, I'll see you guys like my cosplay videos. I love doing cosplay. It is so easy and so fun. And I keep those videos super, super, super short. I mean, short as in less than 60 seconds. So thank you guys for watching those videos. Make sure you continue to watch all my other videos, especially my travel videos. I've been to different parts of Asia, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand. Oh yeah, Indonesia, Bali, Indonesia. So make sure you guys check out those videos and all my other travel videos. And just check me out. Just give me a try. Hit the subscribe button. I love you guys. Thank you. Fight!